Hey guys! Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Teresa Hirado, and today we have another Wish video. These videos always take the most amount of planning because if you guys are unfamiliar with Wish, it's an app that you can buy a lot of really inexpensive items, but they take like a month and a half to get here, and sometimes they just don't get there at all. Little lottery thing you can play with real money. It's not actually like a lottery app, but I've had my ups and downs, and you will see one of the major downs in this video today. I'll get to that when we get into the video, but today we are testing some Wish hair removal products. Now, you guys know I have a series, well, not really a series, but I have like a bunch of videos about removing hair from my face. That was actually one of my top videos when I first started doing YouTube, was how I remove my sideburns, and I still like do my whole facial hair removing stuff. I just had a routine, so I am very interested in like hair removal, so I figured it'd be really fun to try really, really, really inexpensive products. Do you hear that too? Ever hear high-pitched noises or bells and you're just like, am I crazy? Is it in my ear? I know what that would be. Very excited to try these products with you guys, see how they work, if they work at all. Keep watching. All right, so first things first, I'm going to remove my face makeup. I just filmed like a video, or an Instagram video. Went a little heavy on the highlighter, so I'm not too upset about taking the face makeup off. To do facial hair removal, I always remove my makeup just because I don't want to get any further irritation, acne, anything like that from pulling hair out by the root and having makeup like go into the pores. I'm not a scientist, I don't know if that happens, but I just feel like that would make sense. So always remove my makeup. And today we have had three products. They're all here. No, they're all here. Don't worry about that, but I'm gonna open my app and get the products out. Sorry, I'm just talking to Wish customer service. Again, just wait for it. The first item, some of these little baggies. Safe handheld face facial hair removal threading beauty epilator for women. This is what it looks like, this contraption. I've seen this kind of like metal thing. You can use it to kind of thread around your face. I actually have one, but never a giant like three-pronged monster. I'm so scared because this actually does rip the hair out from the root. It is not painless. It is like epilating basically. We're plucking your hair. I paid $1 and then $2 shipping. So they always get you with the shipping. They should have just told me it was $3, but they always do that. I'm scared for this one. The next item I'm not as scared for because I've tried this before. There was a Nasty Not TV product. I can't remember what it was exactly, like name of it, but I feel like it was the exact same concept. It was a pack of two. These guys. Two-piece magic painless hair removal popular depilation sponge pad effective remove tool. They remind me of rice patties. Is it just because I'm hungry? They look like rice patties. It kind of just like chips away at the hair almost like sandpaper, I guess. So at least it doesn't hurt. But yeah, we got those guys. They were free with $3 shipping. They're now $6 with I don't even know how much shipping. So definitely bargain shop when you're on the Wish app because they'll mark the prices up like crazy. And then finally, actually the thing I was most excited for is, let me get the name of it up. Fashion Storm Woman's Beauty Tool Manually Threading Face Facial Spa Hair Remover Epilator. I'll show you the picture up here. It looks really, really cool, and it kind of is the same lines of threading if you ever got your eyebrows threaded. So I thought this would be really cool because it's just a machine that does it for you. You don't have to like worry about angling and all that stuff. This morning, I just wanted to see the product in my hand and be like, okay, familiarize myself. I know at least generally what the three products are. So when I took this one out this morning, this happened. This is what I saw. That's sad. And then I spent the next, I don't even know, 40 minutes probably trying to glue it back together. I don't know why I thought I could do that. I really don't. And this is what I have. I tried Gorilla Glue, I tried nail glue, I tried super glue, duct tape. People say duct tape fixes everything. Don't fix this thing. That's what it looks like right now. This side is supposed to look exactly like this side. I guess like in theory, you're just supposed to like, cause where this crosses, where the hair will get kind of caught in it. So as you move it back and forth, the hair gets like pulled out. But as you can see, that's not gonna work anymore. Unfortunately, we're not gonna be able to try him. And that was a very frustrating 40 minutes. I have a refill pack too, which is delightful. When you buy it, they give you this so that you can use it time and time again, unless it comes broken in half. It is kind of cool looking. There are strings with beads on the end of them. That's how they go into the little machine. We even call it a machine. There's that one. So I think the first one that we should try is Mr. Painful over here. I used to have just, it's a long one of these little spring guys, and you just put them in a U and kind of go over your face and it pulls out the hair. It just gets caught in the coils. It's kind of doing the same thing. So when I push the handle, the coils expand. And when I stop pushing the handle, the coils like go in, and it's painful. painful. Oh, it's painful. And so I can't even imagine what this triple duty guy is gonna do. I guess right here, this kind of hair is starting to grow back a little bit now. Hit my face a little bit. That's what I always do when I epilate, just to get my skin primed and ready for pain. So the instructions are wash the face with warm water until the pores open. We're not gonna do that, it's fine. Hold the handles on both ends of the hair removal with both hands and place the hair removal close to the skin. Rotate the two handles outwards in the direction shown in the figure, which I think just means let go of the handles. The device will roll from the bottom to the top of the face so that the facial hair can be completely removed. Oh my God, it's gonna hurt so bad. Try to look dignified when we do this. Here we go. Ugh. I hate bringing you guys closer. Did you see that? Oh my gosh. Oh, it's definitely getting it. I can see the hairs in there. All these little like peach fuzzes. That I can barely see. I don't know if I'd be able to like show it to you guys. Oh my gosh. It's pulling it out by the root. I see any of the hair in there. It'll be so light. As dark as my hair is, my peach fuzz is obviously like still really light. So 100% that works. There's definitely like lots of hairs in there. It's three of them working together, so that's really good. The thing that which is a personal issue, problem I have with this is that this is to pull out peach fuzz. You could use it to like pull out the bigger hairs. Problem is it's not very accurate, whereas in since you are having to come at it at angles, you're not getting every single hair, because if you look at the COIL, and I just feel like it's a little bit slower than a regular epilator if you wanted to pull out like a ton of hair by the root. And for peach fuzz in general, my issue is I don't really care about the peach fuzz on my face, and it's hurting so much that I just don't find it worth it. Like I said, you can hardly see it in here. I tried to show you all the hair it's taking out, because it's taking out a lot, so you're not gonna see it on my face either. And if you did, because it's so minuscule and like unseen, I could take a shaver, save myself the pain, and get rid of any hair that I think is there, or that is there, but that I think is maybe showing. But I mean, some people really like this stuff, and ow though. I have to really love the process, the results, everything about it, if I'm gonna put myself in that much pain, because epilating hurts, like that hurts a lot too. But this one just seems like it's gonna put me in pain for a little bit longer, and I'll have to do it for a longer time. Did work though. Definitely if you're into like doing that little thing and you want to do it three times as much, then why not? Next item, well, the last item. Thank you, Wish, for that. Are these little rice patty things. Oh, I wish I would remember the name of whatever it was that I had when I was, I think I was like 15 or something when these came out on a scene on TV, and I bought it and it worked. It worked really good, and it took all the hair off, and it was this soft. Like when you feel, it feels smooth. It doesn't feel like there's anything crazy going on, but it's kind of like a magic eraser, how a magic eraser feels really smooth and soft. But the way that it works is it's chipping away whatever the stain is, all that kind of stuff. It's chipping away very minorly, like super, super micro. So that's what I thought maybe this was. There's a piece of hair in it, and I can't tell if it's mine, but it's like in the sponge. I don't know if I could do that. I can leave that guy alone. We're gonna go to the other one. Good thing they gave me two. It says, make your skin wet first. Use the pink circle rotation in one direction friction. Rub up and down briskly for 1 minute in the same position. It's saying this is the front and this is the back, which to me means the front is the useful side. The back is just the make it wet side. So you're using one of them to make your skin wet, and the other to like ferociously, briskly, sorry, rub up and down. Try it. I don't know if you can tell. Like, I wet the area, and then we're just gonna go back and forth. I swear the other one wanted me to go in circles. The one that I got when I was like 15. Oh, it took it off. That's so cool. What is it doing to my skin? Okay, so that 100% definitely does work. This hurts a little bit, my skin. It could be my head, I can't tell. It just like feels a little bit carpet burn, I guess you can say. It definitely did take off the hair. I'm seeing, I don't know if it's from my skin or from this pink sticker, whatever the sticker's made out of, but it does look like there's a little bit of, almost like I exfoliated my skin. Definitely took that hair off, which is like weird. I thought the same thing back then. I was like, how is this even working? Maybe I should look it up. Move the way. That was fun. I also realized that I didn't check out anyone else's videos. Not only is this not an original video, which I really didn't think it was gonna be, because I was like, of course people have tried hair removal products from Wish, but there are some videos of people that tried the exact same products. So might have seen it before, but you haven't seen me do it. It's what I say to all the videos where I'm like, crap, I had no idea. I really can't find where it's telling me definitively why these work, but I did find a quick article here, may or may not be true, about someone who ordered a refill pack from Amazon, and it was like the same kind that they had used before with the Smooth Away. Those you could like refill. And they peeled off the back and it legit says silicone carbide waterproof abrasive paper electro-coated. Oh, the coated spelled weird. Silicone carbide. So it's like sandpaper. Maybe that is what this legit is, just sandpaper. But I mean, it did work. I'm kind of scared of rubbing sandpaper all over myself. Obviously, it's not painful, but I don't know if that could like age me. I mean, usually not the first thing you think about your legs, about aging your legs. But I don't know. It just feels like I shouldn't be putting that on my skin. What do you guys think? Have you tried anything like this before, back when it was the Smooth Away? Although these are a lot cheaper and they work the same way. Those are the products. I'm sorry I didn't have a third one for you guys because it arrived broken, but maybe we'll try this again if I can find any other products on there. Maybe I can get it sent again and not have it break. We'll see. But I hope you guys like watching these other products, even if you might have seen them in some other videos. Apparently, they're quite popular, weird things to buy on Wish. And also, if you're interested in buying anything from Wish, I don't know if you're interested in buying these products, but I do. Everyone who signs up with Wish gets a coupon code they can give to people. It's like a mystery code, so when you do your first order, if you put it in, you'll get anywhere from like 5 to 50% off. But I'll leave that down below if you're ordering for the first time so you can save some money. And if you have not already subscribed, definitely subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can be alerted when I put out a new video. I'll see you in my next one. Bye!